Happy Tuesday, everyone, and hello from the Lebanon Senior Center. It's another interesting day of the year 2020, isn't it? Last night, you all might have started getting concerned for the ash and the smoke that was filling the air, and I don't blame you. Definitely something to be concerned about. And you know, some might say a little ironic considering our themed activity for this month is preparedness. Last week we got started on this journey of reviewing, looking at, and for some people starting to plan for emergencies. And I hope that you're following along, definitely in light of the different events that are happening around us. It's never too late. Well, I might change that. Hopefully, you won't experience it being too late to prepare for an emergency. Now is a great time. If you haven't started planning or preparing for emergency, start. I know it can seem overwhelming, it can seem daunting, but it's a good time to start thinking about things that you might need to do if there was to be an emergency, whether it be a personal emergency, such as a house fire, or community emergency. We have been under the pandemic situation for much of 2020 at this point. We're learning to live new lives, how to do things, wearing masks, what to do to stay safe against that. But just because we're going through one state of emergency doesn't mean another emergency can't come along. Last week we talked about hurricanes hitting Louisiana. This week there's wildfires that are affecting our lives. So it's only appropriate, as we have neighbors around us that some unfortunately are having to think about evacuations. We are not, and we're feeling very fortunate about that right now. But this week's theme is those go kits, the emergency kits. So what do we need to have in case of emergency thought? Last week we talked about communication. This week, what you need to pack. So this week's packet that you can pick up here at the center, give us a call at 541-258-4919 here in Lebanon. We'll happily bring one out to you, to your car. Or we can even mail it to you. It is also on our Facebook page if you would like to get that information there. But it's got this lovely list printed on the front. It is a couple pages long, which can seem really daunting, but there's a lot to think about. And not everything on the list might meet your situation. On the back pages, there are some things to think about for if you've got animals that are evacuating with you. And some other scenarios that may or may not be appropriate for you. You may also think of things that you need, that you feel you really need, that aren't on this list. And we encourage you to look over it, think about it. Definitely add things to it that you feel you need to take with you. But definitely pick one up and start working on it. Or if you feel you've already got a kit and a go bag ready in case of emergencies, pick up a list. It definitely is something to review and look at. Look at the stuff in your kit. Is everything still there? Did you accidentally store the batteries in the flashlight and now those batteries are no good and they've corroded and damaged your flashlight? These are important things to check out before you need to use them. Attached to the kit, there's also an emergency preparedness guide that was written by seniors for seniors and developed through the American Red Cross. Some of this information will be duplicate from things we shared last week, but it's an interesting read and flip through, definitely from the perspective of seniors for seniors. So definitely pick up your information. If you follow along and are doing your preparedness checks, by giving us a call here at the center and letting us know what you're up to, what you've been working on, you can get entered into our contest. This week we're giving away these mini water filtration kits, really kind of cool. You can see it's not so much bigger than my hand, but evidently it can do 100,000 gallons of water purification. That's pretty incredible for a little device. So definitely, hopefully you are participating and getting your gear ready. I brought some of my bags along with me. These are ones that double as hiking bags, but you know, if you were to get stuck out in the woods and have to sustain yourself for a while, there are some items that kind of translate into what you need out there versus what you need to survive anywhere. So get your kit together and get it started. One of the tips and tricks I've heard recently that I think is really great from one of our bus drivers, he recommends everybody should have a headlamp. So this is a headlamp, pretty cool. It's like a flashlight you can wear on your head, which is, you know, keeps your hands free in case of emergency. So he highly recommends having a headlamp as a flashlight for your bag. I've also heard another really cool tip about go bags for seniors. So go bags are like a pack that would sustain you for 3 days. And a lot of thought kind of went into this tip, I think, thinking of seniors and ergonomics specifically. One person recommended using some kind of rolling case, either a backpack with wheels or a small suitcase with wheels. That way, you know, if carrying things that can get heavier, and we're talking 3 days worth of water, food, and all of the materials you're going to need to sustain yourself, can get a little heavy. So maybe having on wheels would be a good idea if carrying that around might seem like a daunting task. So sometimes even selecting the right bag or carrying mechanism can be a big part in your readiness. So go ahead, pick up a list today to start working on that kit. Don't forget to give us a call here at the center, 541-258-4919. Let us know that you've been working on it. If you let us know that you've been working on your go bag, your go kit by next Tuesday, by noon next Tuesday, we'll get you entered in our contest to win the filtration kit. This week, winner is receiving the hand crank radio, radio flashlight and charger. It's a whole bunch of things to win. So they're pretty excited to be winning those. If you guys have questions, please plop them down in the comments or give us a call. You guys take care. Stay safe out there. Really be careful with the smoke and ash. Definitely, hopefully, you better have masks in your emergency kits by now and wearing them on your face. Be well. Stay safe. We'll talk to you soon.